George Klein on Memphis Sounds, an old friend with us today, known her for many, many years. She dated Elvis in high school, went to the prom with the king and all. Miss Dixie Locke Emmons. Dixie, how you doing?
Good, George, thank you.
How do you stay so beautiful all these years?
Oh, you're very kind, thank you.
What's your secret is,
girl? Us older girls have to work a little harder.
Dixie, you have retired from First Assembly, they tell me.
I have. I've been retired 2 years now, after 30 years.
Wow. Many wonderful memories over there.
Oh, absolutely.
Dixie, you met Elvis and dated him early on. Can you talk about your early relationship with Elvis and just give us some stories?
Okay, I will. Elvis and I went to the same church together. I've been at First Assembly since I was 8 years old. So that was my home church. And when his family moved to Memphis from Tupelo, they started coming to First Assembly. The big drawing card, I believe, that drew them besides the Pentecostal denomination was that the Blackwood Brothers Quartet were all members of First Assembly. And Elvis loved the Blackwood Brothers, of course, and
sure
the gospel
did.
Music.
Yeah.
So that's why he started coming to the church. He was about 3.5 years older than me, so we were not in the same classes together, but we were in the same Sunday school area and church together, so that's where we met.
Well, Dixie, how was it? You tell a cute story about the skating party and all.
Okay, well, we had, I had seen Elvis, of course, at church for a good while, but, you know, we kind of had eyes on each other, I think, but both of us were kind of shy. We were just teenagers, and so we never really went up to speak to each other, but one Sunday after church, a group of my girlfriends and I were talking, and Elvis and a couple of boys were over not far from us. And we started talking loud enough for the boys to hear that we were going to Rainbow Skating Rink that Saturday night to skate. And we kind of just threw it out there to see if they were paying attention, if they would come. So that Saturday night, we did go to the skating rink, and Elvis showed up, not with the other guys, just him by himself. And so when I saw him, I went over to introduce myself to him. I said, I don't know if you know who I am or not. And he said, oh, yes, I do. And so we just, you know, we just started a conversation. I've laughed since that time. Well, we said that later. It was very obvious that he didn't skate.
Yeah.
So, you know, he just kind of held to the pole while we were standing there. But I took off my skates and sat down with him that night. And we spent the rest of the night just kind of getting to know each other. So when the skating session was over, he asked if he could take me home that night. We had ridden the bus out there. So he carried me home that night, and we started dating.
Well, didn't something funny happen on the first date? He came to your home. He once told me your dad wouldn't let you go with him or
That's
something.
That's right. When he brought me home the first time he brought me home from the skating rink, he asked me to go out with him the next weekend. And I told him yes, that I would, without checking with my parents. And when he came to pick me up the next weekend, my parents wouldn't let me leave the house with him because he was not...
A little different, huh?
He was a little different from the rest of the boys from school, you know. So my parents wouldn't let us leave. We spent our first date in the house with my mother and daddy and three sisters and played Monopoly, and that was our first date.
Okay, now when he took you, Dixie, to the Southside Prom, I think it was...
Mm-hmm.
He was already starting to, he'd already recorded for Sun Records.
Yes,
Talk
he had.
About that, going to the prom with Elvis.
Well, it was an exciting time, of course. We had started dating, actually our first date was January 54, so his record had not been released until later that year, June, if I remember correctly. Excuse me. So we had dated through those times, and by 55, it was my junior prom. And he was already doing some singing shows on the Louisiana Hayride and had made several appearances here in the Memphis area, not anything real on the national level yet. But he was quite well known. So he drove back actually from Louisiana to be there for my junior prom.
Yeah.
And when we went in to the prom that night, you know, he was quite a hit with everybody there.
Everybody knew who he was at that time,
yes,
didn't they?
Yes, they did. They
Dixie,
sure did.
I want to ask you, is there any one little thing, any cute little story that nobody knows about Elvis you want to share with us?
Well, you know, I don't know, George, if I can tell one that everyone doesn't know. There's been so many wonderful stories told about his personal life and private life. I just, when someone asks me that, I usually say to them that so many people that loved him and followed his career really didn't know the true Southern gentleman and the compassionate young man that he was growing up.
Very true, yeah.
And so when I hear people that have known him in later years, it's almost like a different person to me because I, of course, you know, I married and raised a family after that time, so I didn't follow his career as closely as a lot of people did. But I said the times that I knew him during the young, innocent, early days of his career, and just saw what a loving, compassionate man he was. It was very special.
Dixie, did he ever talk about going into show business early on when you were dating?
He did. He did talk about that, and that was his, you know, that was his dream to do that. I don't think that ever in his imagination, certainly not in any of us that knew him at that time, had any idea of the scope of his popularity that it would be. It was just, it was an amazing thing. There had never been anything like it before.
Right.
So, you know, there was no way to say you're going to measure him against somebody because there was no one who had ever done anything.
He was the trailblazer, the pioneer
of
rock and roll. Dixie, thanks so much for coming down.
You're so welcome, George.
Dixie Locke Emmons. Boy, it's good talking to you. You bring back wonderful memories every time I see you.
Thank you, George.
Dixie Locke Emmons, Memphis Sounds for GK.